this work has been a thread of what's kept me turning back towards life.
Oh, I mean,
it's a big question.
I came into this work really lost. So, can I have a moment?
I am embodied. I'm a warrior. I'm an activist. I'm a healer. I'm an educator. I'm an artist. I am a spiritual being.
I'm nonconformist. I am extremely clear about who I am. I know where I come from.
I am a somatic therapist.
In Ghana, I work with kids with special needs.
I've always worked with dance and body and a lot of different populations.
I'm standing as a queer elder now.
I train people in communication, so I'm very verbal.
I'm from Uganda. I work with an organization that uses breakdance for positive social change around the slums.
I come from living in Israel-Palestine and working with Israel, Jordan, and Palestine, working on solving shared environmental issues that are cross-border. There's different ways of solving conflict or living with conflict without killing each other.
So I come from a country that experiences crisis, war, corruption, and all sort of violence against humanity.
I don't feel the support, the community support around me out in just regular life.
I was lost. I didn't know where I was going. I remember like feeling so enraged that I couldn't see nothing around me.
We don't have resources. We come from segregation. Trauma.
People spend a lot of time in their minds, and that can lead to like anxiety and depression.
It's easy to get lost, and it's easy to be sucked into despair and freeze and paralyzation and hopelessness.
So the communities that we work with, it's very unsafe. I feel like the girls are having so much to deal with at the very young age that they don't have enough tools and resources to process what they're dealing with.
There's so much burnout. There's so much people giving up, and there is people taking their own lives. We're constantly facing the labor of teaching others about our lives to feel safe.
I work in spaces with people who are incarcerated. All of my clients have been traumatized in one way or many.
When I work with people, I'm asking a lot of them because I'm really asking them to talk about their trauma.
If you look at all that is happening, you see how the ladies are so disconnected with who they are as like human beings. You see how they just like really operate in silos.
We're working to decolonize systems at this point. And in order to be able to do that kind of work, to be able to make systemic change, we have to be in right relationship with ourselves and with the earth, with our ancestors, with the elders.
The world needs healing and needs leaders who are going to step up and meet the challenges of today.
We're in massive transition as a species, as a planet. The template of transition that we go through individually it helps us to learn about how to navigate those greater transitions we're facing collectively.
It's challenging also to come from inside to try to change a little bit things. So inside the structure, inside institutions that can be so rigid.
We're not gonna be perfect. We're not always gonna do it right, but how do we meet the years of impact and the hurt and take accountability?
I just think that there's no other way in these times but in our bodies. There's so much disconnect in the world right now, and a core aspect of this work is connection.
There's so many roles, and there's so many ways to perform what's right, and the shoulds, and the wouldas, and I'm supposed to be this way. And having access to my body has allowed me to get in right relationship with what's true for me and how I actually want to be in the world.
For trans and non-binary youth, the body is such a contentious area.
Our body is our tool. It's simple as that. And if we are disconnected from it, we don't have tools anymore.
Sometimes when you have trauma, it gets deep-seated in your body.
How can you feel connected, resourced, or even aware of what's happening around you if you're not, you know, if you're not connected and in your body?
Yeah, our bodies hold so much and our movements hold so much.
We can't be of service if we don't know how to take care of ourselves. So it's a lot of doing our cleaning, what I call housekeeping, in order to really be a resource for other people and for other situations in the world.
Being a provider is hard. It's intense. I'm exposed to collective pain and mental illness and families and meltdowns, you know, a lot of intensity. I just took all of that and brought it to the dance floor.
When you're able to use your mind and your body, your soul and your core, when those are in alignment and when there's connection, there's movement with clarity that can happen. We have the tools to be able to stay in ourselves.
In the dance, we move through a full cycle and a range of experience. And at the end of that, of really feeling completion and stillness and compassion and gratitude, I have learned how to know the intricacies of my body through this work.
Knowing how to be in relationship with the threshold crossings, how to be in active relationship with the rhythms of life, the rhythms of the body, the emotions, the range of emotions that present themselves in our bodies.
As a rabbi in today's world, this work has breathed such new life for me into the frameworks that already are there and have been there since ancient times. For me to understand what it actually means and marking thresholds really helps us to make meaning of our lives.
I came here and I saw people shaking. I was like, okay, this is not the camp I was supposed to be on. But after that, like, there's so much energy that was going on, and everything just poured out from me, and I was like, ooh, I needed this.
Movement is a natural way of expression. It takes very little for you to express yourself through movement than it takes for you to express yourself through word.
What I've always treasured about SomaSource is the way that it brings in spirit, justice, emotional healing, and community in the same breath, in an embodied way.
I would say that SomaSource is an amazing modality to learn how to express your feelings, how to work through trauma, and also to be really an embodied social justice activist, artist, teacher, leader, healer.
Rites of passage, initiatory experiences, threshold experiences, markings of times in our lives, and honoring those is a lost form, it's a lost art, and desperately needed, especially for the youth in these times.
When I think of a future of embodied leaders, think about a shift in what we view and have normed as expertise. So indigenous ways of thinking, having intergenerational presence at the table, having a diversity of background, of thought, of experience, of thinking, artists alongside scientists and engineers.
To be connected to one's body, it's not a matter of a second, but it's a work that takes months, weeks, years.
I'm really touched by this work and to see after 12 years to continue being here.
The work of Golden Bridge and SomaSource has given me lots of gift. Today I know who I am. I know what I want with my life.
When I come here, it is like just, you know, being seen in a way that doesn't happen very often.
Now that I'm healing this whole big wound that I had in my past, now I feel that I can finally love myself and other people.
Through the process, I felt like I was even more alive than I had ever been in my life, actually.
What if more people of all ages, especially the youth, you know, to have this experience?
Today, I feel grounded and ready to go and share this medicine with my colleagues and friends and youth in my community.
It's changing the world already, and I hope it continues to change the world.
I feel very clear about my journey, about knowing that it's of service to youth, and also with balancing how to self-manage and take care of self too, so that I can keep showing up for other people.
What this work does so well and Golden Bridge does so well is empower leaders to go out into the world and then do their brand of their work with this as like informing how they show up as leaders, and it's really beautiful. And so I'm always excited to see what everyone is doing and how their different manifestations of this work happen.